Hello there guys, welcome back to the channel and welcome to Survival Russia. The weather mega sucks. We are at the TP camp, as you can see, the plastic TP camp, and we're gonna do an overnight here. This is most likely some of the worst, baddest survival weather we can think of, because it's 0 degrees or plus half a degree or something like this. It's kind of actually raining a little bit and it's windy, and we have very long nights, 18-19 hours by now. So let's get to it. This is where it will snow and rain because of this. So since I have a poncho with me, I think we should try and repair it a little bit. I will not mess around too much with this here. We had snow again and it's melting again. So yeah, we can see we can straighten it out just a little bit. And then I think we're gonna try and wrap a poncho around it here and let's see how that goes. One thing we don't have on this trip here is food. It's actually a very, very minimalistic trip. I do have a light sleep system and a ground pad and a silky saw. We also need to get some firewood running because we're gonna need a little bit of fire in the teepee here. The reason I made the shelter for the guys of you who do not know is that I for a long time been thinking about what is a good shelter. Oh, we have a mess kit. That's a good thing. What's a good survival shelter? Simple, fast, and something we can make a little bit of a fire in. So the only thing I could really come up with was a plastic sheet of plastic, construction plastic, and a teepee, bank line. Let's see what we can do with this poncho here. We can close it off just a little bit. That will not be too bad actually. We have some birch bark and some fat wood. It's just dry because out there everything is just soaking wet. It's really bad. It's been the second day. But in here it starts to look pretty awesome. But I also need to find some firewood, guys. Because we of course need to get this fire going so we can dry out some of these sticks there, which I've collected last time we were here. We have some there, pine stuff. I do have a small axe with me, so we have to economize with it the best we can. We definitely need a small fire in there. And if you guys are enjoying the content on the channel, then please consider supporting the channel in the links in the description and in a pinned comment. You can do that via RBM Outdoors, there's an affiliate link. You can shop there, support the channel. Boosty is a good option. It's a safe international site which does not hate Russia. So that is a really good option. Subscribestar is also a good option. There's links in the description to that. And in the pinned comment, that would be awesome, guys. Because, as you know, I'm in Russia. So I have been forcefully demonetized by YouTube. Awesome. Supposedly, I'm a YouTube partner, but they don't want to make me earn any money from my content. That's a good partnership. Thank you. Thank you, YouTube. Awesome. We also have an option to head over to one of the other campsites and see if we have some leftover firewood there, because I have one campsite over there, you know, with the permanent shelter. It could be interesting to check that out. It's been standing for, I don't know, 4 or 5 years by now. And I have another campsite even further out, but I don't have the time for that. Well, it's gonna get dark in not too long, and then it's gonna have a long night. So I don't know. We'll see what we can do. I'll see what I can come up with. So before we move on, I would like to give a fast shout out to a knife maker, knife company called QSP Knives. So QSP actually sent me 3 knives. They're all awesome. This is we're gonna take a look at later. Turtle Punk. Nice knife. This is a liner lock. They're all a little bit different, but this is also 14C28N. This guy here is called Graby T. It's a little bit different. But we're going to take a look at that, as I said, later. It is a different steel. It is 35, what is it called? S35VN. It's a relatively expensive steel. What I'm carrying at the moment is this little guy here, the Ripley. It's awesome. It's light. G10 handle and all that good stuff. Sharp, nice, locks nicely. So I'm definitely a knife guy. I carry 4 knives on my body, maybe a fifth. I have a fifth in my backpack because I have a Gerber tool there. But anyway, what was interesting to me about this company is that they mainly make their knives, the blades, out of what is it called? C14 28N. Sandvik steel. And the Sandvik steel I like a lot, because this little Mora here is made from that exact steel. So far I've been carrying this for a few weeks now. It's pretty awesome. It's very, very light. And one thing I like about it is that we have a ferro rod here, right? We actually have a combi rod, ferro magnesium rod. And the spine of the blade is not really sharp enough to make a spark. It can do it, but this little part out here can actually do it. So not completely useless, actually. But nice little knife overall. And since QSP knives have been sort of like supporting my channel here, then at least go and check them out. They make really awesome knives, and they have made a lot of awesome folders. They have a few fixed blades, but not that many. But folders are definitely their thing. So go and check them out, because they have not paid me anything for this. But what I do is that I will definitely sell the 2 other knives. So that kind of supports the channel a little bit. All right, guys. So we were actually on the way over to the main campsite. It's not far from here. But I got the feeling that it was a bad idea. And oftentimes in the forest, in the nature, it's good to listen to your hunches and so on. So we're gonna try and work with what we have. I saw some prints from snowshoe hare, coon dog, fox, and wild boar. I have my backpack on, because of course, brought my backpack with me, as I always say, as you heard me say many times, don't leave your gear behind, because that's a bad decision. Yeah, no bear tracks or anything like that. Bear should be sleeping, but who knows? It's very warm. But this is what our former dry poncho looks like now. It's not really raining, we just have this mist coming down. And it's been coming down for like at least 2 days now or something. It's pretty annoying actually. So we're gonna check out how a fire works in this tent here, because that was one of my self-made criteria. It should be possible to make a small fire, not very big, one small one as we can see, because outside it is really unpleasant. As you most likely can see, we have quite a good wind going on, so let's see how this goes. And then we're gonna hit the sack, that's for sure. Because it's cold and unpleasant, that is for dang sure. But this is not too bad at all, guys. Just what I wanted, actually. Smoke is not too bad if we're just sitting low. And I mean, if we need a shelter, that's because it's bad weather. Most likely something with wet weather. This is the ideal conditions for testing this type of shelter here. And of course, as I say, it's chilly. I mean, I don't even have long johns on or anything. I only use long johns when it gets minus 10 and below. So that's how that is. But anyway, this is enough to heat water, cook a little bit, heat hands, this and that. I could make it bigger than that, actually. And it's of course a good idea to keep it clean burning. I think it's just time to hit the sack, basically. So we are actually in the bags, because it's two bags. We have a kind of a jungle bag or very light bag, and then we have this outer bag here, which me and Mr. Safari Russia, we have shamelessly copied the Yavin bag. I do have a Yavin bag, but this is a little bit more insulated than the one I have. So yeah, it's quite awesome, actually. It should definitely be enough for around 0 degrees. I put out the fire, but as a final remark here, before I close up, is that all this shelter building here I made, I think I made this shelter already in September, actually, in the t-shirt and everything. But I've been thinking about it a long time, and that's why I always say, get out and train. Get it done, and then also do something awesome, of course. But if you want to, you know, find out what it takes to survive and all that good stuff, camping, survival camping, then we need to get out and train, and that's what I've done with this shelter, because now I know how to make it, which materials I need, how to measure the sticks here with my arms and so on, so I know which length I need for this diameter and blah blah blah. I verified we can actually make a fire in here without any bigger problems. I could make it a lot larger and so on. So that's what I mean with the get out and train and get it done and do something awesome, basically. So if nothing more, then get out and train, get it done and do something awesome, and please consider supporting the channel. That would be really awesome, because that's actually the only thing that keeps the channel running. More about that later. But anyway, guys, see you in the next one.